So WhatsApp has updated its privacy policy, and it will obviously cause more concern because this does bring deeper integrations with Facebook, which is its parent company. And we'll take a look at what does this privacy policy mean, whether you have to accept it, and what does it mean for your data on WhatsApp. So basically, WhatsApp's privacy policy has gotten an update, and as always, it's a cause for concern because it's used by over a billion people. But this is pretty standard practice as far as most companies go. Almost all companies do update their privacy policies at some point or the other. And in order to continue using them, you have to accept these terms of service and the new updated privacy policy. So it's not like this is some radically different thing that WhatsApp is doing. It's what you usually see when you're using any piece of software, be it a pop-up messaging app or, you know, say, or photo editor or anything. And with regard to the major changes in the privacy policy, it's now reflecting a lot of the deeper integrations that are there between WhatsApp and Facebook, which is also expected considering that WhatsApp is part of the Facebook group of companies and there would be more integrations between them. And we've seen that Facebook has also rolled out features such as Rooms to WhatsApp itself, WhatsApp Pay, so which brings more integration with other Facebook products. So the privacy policy is you know, going to reflect a lot of those data changes. It's also been updated to show how businesses interact with you, since businesses on WhatsApp has become another big aspect. And we've seen that Facebook and WhatsApp are pushing for that as well. Okay, so nothing has essentially changed with WhatsApp, right? WhatsApp still remains end-to-end encrypted, and your messages are not really shared with Facebook because it is an end-to-end encrypted platform. So that part has not changed. However, there is a lot of other kind of information sharing which is going to happen, say when you make transactions on WhatsApp, when you shop on WhatsApp, when you do, when you interact with third-party integrations on WhatsApp, which might be using, you know, Facebook's products for making interactions better. So there will be data sharing around there, and WhatsApp has in the privacy policy listed out a lot of these, which will include, for instance, there is data sharing happening for integrity of security systems around what kind of messages might be considered as spam messages. So all that kind of sharing is happening, and it's been elaborated a lot more in the privacy policy now. To say that user data is suddenly a lot more vulnerable would not be entirely correct, because the messages are still end-to-end encrypted on WhatsApp. So WhatsApp has finally launched payments last year. They got commissioned payments in India, and they are launching payments in other countries as well. With regard to payments, remember that whenever you use WhatsApp to make any kind of payment, the data around that is also processed by WhatsApp, which could be the, you know, the WhatsApp payment information, the transaction amount, all of that. Each country has its own specific privacy policy for payments, and it's best that users go through that before they start using payments on WhatsApp. So WhatsApp has also elaborated more on the hardware information that it's collecting. Now it includes battery strength, signal strength, your ISP, the device model number that you're using, which country you're located in, the country code, the country, all of that kind of data is related to your device hardware, your device identifier for advertising purposes. All of that is also being collected. And this portion has significantly increased compared to what we saw in the previous version. So yes, of course, as I pointed out before, you will have to accept these new terms of service and this new privacy policy in order to continue using WhatsApp, because that is the standard approach. Companies do, as I said, update their policies, and WhatsApp has given users, I think, till February 8th, 2021 to accept these new terms of services. And you would have seen that in the notice as well if you've logged into WhatsApp. So yeah, this is where the policy might cause some confusion, but what it's really doing is actually clarifying a lot of things. So if you just simply delete the WhatsApp app from your phone, That doesn't mean that your WhatsApp account gets deleted. That data is still with WhatsApp because you haven't actually gone into the WhatsApp settings and asked for your account to be deleted. In order for your account to be deleted, you have to go into the settings and choose the delete my account option, and then your data will be removed with WhatsApp. This data includes your phone number, your name, groups that you might be part of, all of that, which you can browse through in the privacy policy. Do keep in mind that even if you delete your WhatsApp account entirely, if you are, if you've been part of other groups, if your chats with other people, those will not be deleted because those people are still using WhatsApp, right? And so that information is likely to remain.